In this video, we'll be talking about how to select and edit an object within the program 3ds Max. So after you've created an object like I've done here, you want to be able to edit the object to form a shape that is more detailed than just the basic primitive. So there's many different ways to do this, and the method I'm going to show you is using the editable polygon method here. So there's really two different ways to do this. I can actually choose this from the modifier list underneath the command panel. If I scroll down, I'm able to see an option that says Edit Poly. This allows me to, in my modifier list, create a stack here, so which has my basic parameters, but then also has my modifier, which is my Edit Poly. So I could also undo that. I can also right-click over the object and choose Convert to Editable Poly. So the main difference is that I don't have those basic parameters options if I choose the Edit Poly option and right-clicking over the object. But if I use the modifier list, the actual Edit Poly modifier, it actually does the same thing at the same options, but within the modifier list, I'm able to keep the parameters and edit the parameters later if I want to. But either way, it comes up with the same options here. So under the Edit Poly menu here, I have different ways to be able to select my subcomponent methods here. So I'm able to edit the object's vertices, edges, borders, polygons, or elements. So there's three different ways, main ways, to be able to select the subcomponent methods of this Edit Poly object. So the first method is under the modifier list. If I select vertex, edge, border, polygon, or element by name, and I'm able to come in here and actually select that component and move them around manually. So I could also, underneath that, select it by the picture, vertex, edge, border, polygon, or element. There actually is a third way by using the keyboard shortcuts, and it does the same method, same line. One is for vertex, two is for edge, three is for border, four is for polygon, and five is for element. So those are the three main ways to be able to select an object subcomponent methods underneath the editable poly menu. So if I move to an option like the vertex subcomponent, and I drag select over some vertices, I'm able to edit those by just moving those. If I get the rotate, I can actually rotate these. I get the scale tool, I can scale these in or out. So those are my three main options. That was using W, E, and R. W is move, E is rotate, R is scale. You can actually select those same tools up here in the toolbar by these three menus right here. So, but if I come in here and drag select over vertices, for example, it selects the faces, the vertices that are in front of me, but also selects the ones behind me. Might not always be what I want to do. Maybe I just want to select these up here, but I don't have to worry about coming here and deselecting these on the bottom. So instead, it has this option underneath the selection menu that says ignore backfacing. So let me deselect the vertices that I had selected and choose ignore backfacing, so the check mark is beside the box. Now if I drag select over the vertices, it won't select any of the vertices on the back of the face. That's a really nice and helpful tool underneath the selection menu. Move over here to the polygon subcomponent mode. So now if I come over here and select the polygon or a face on the object, I can translate, rotate, or scale these, but I can also be able to shrink or grow my selection. Now if I only have one subcomponent selected, then I cannot shrink that anymore, but then I can also grow this. So if I hit the grow button a couple times, that'll grow my selection out from the center of my first selection that I made. So I can also hit shrink and it'll shrink back down to the lowest amount of selection that it can. So that's the shrink and grow option. So move over here to edge. If I select an edge, I can also have an option where I can choose a ring or a loop. So the ring will choose a vertical loop here around the object until it reaches a point. So if I select an edge, if I select an edge and then I click the ring tool, it selects this kind of column of edges vertically. Or I can actually even do that horizontally. If I select a vertical edge and choose ring, it'll select a kind of column of those edges, ones that aren't touching but are kind of in a horizontal or vertical fashion around the object. So that's ring. If I select an edge and choose loop, that will select edges that are connected to that edge, so as many as it can until it reaches a point. Then you can also select an edge and then choose loop around horizontally, and it'll select that edge loop all the way around. So loop is edges that are connecting, ring is edges that are in a column. So there's also the soft selection menu, which is right underneath the selection menu. So if I hit that plus symbol beside the soft selection, it scrolls open my soft selection menu, and I can choose use soft selection. You go over here and move to like vertices mode, so I'll be able to easily select this. If I select a vertice now, and if I turn use soft selection on, to make sure the use soft selection is on, and get my move tool, you'll see my manipulation is a little bit different. It has coloration changes now, and I'm actually able to move more than one vertice. So it does have a fall off, so the one you select is the one that's going to move the most, and then the vertices around it will move a little bit less, depending on your fall off, and some of the other options as well. So if I turn the fall off up some, so let's turn it up to 30, so it changes the coloration a little bit more, and actually allows me to move my selection a little more. So similar to the way the shrink and grow option works, but now it's just an easier method to be able to edit more vertices or more faces or edges at one time. So I can turn this even up even higher and move even more vertices around. So it just depends on the fall off and the options that you do have selected underneath the soft selection tab. So there's some basic ways to be able to select the object to make working in 3ds Max a little bit easier for you.